In this video, we will talk about pollination and its types. The process of pollination means transfer of pollen grains. Transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma. This process is known as pollination, and we classify this into two main categories as self-pollination and cross-pollination. Self-pollination is further subdivided into two types. One is called autogamy, and the second one is known as gametogamy. Autogamy means transfer of pollen. Transfer of pollen from anther to stigma of the same flower. Of the same flower. That means here the flower has to be bisexual. Then only it would have anther and stigma both. So anther would produce pollen grains, and the pollen grains would get transferred to the stigma of the same flower. Then that type of self-pollination is known as autogamy. In case of gametogamy, it is transfer of pollen from one flower, or rather let us write, from anther of one flower to the stigma of another flower of the same plant. The difference is here in the first case, it is getting transferred, the pollen grain is getting transferred from the anther to the stigma of the single flower. In this case, the flower has to be bisexual. Here, the transfer is from anther of one flower to the stigma of another flower of the same plant. That means one plant either having bisexual flowers. So one flower's anther would produce pollen grains, and those pollens would get transferred to the stigma of the other flower. But the plant is same. The other situation could be that the plant may have unisexual flower. So the male flower would produce pollen grain, and these pollen grains get transferred to the female flower on the same plant. Then in this case, this would be termed as self-pollination. Cross-pollination is also known as xenogamy or allogamy. And in this case, it is transfer of pollen from anther of one flower of one plant to the stigma of another flower of another plant of the same species. So here one flower is on one plant, other flower is on another plant. So from one flower's anther, the pollen grains which are produced, they'll get transferred to the other plant. And that other plant is going to have that flower whose stigma is going to receive that pollen grain. In this case, there would be an agency required. How would the pollen grain move from anther of one flower of a plant to some other flower of some other plant of the same species? There has to be an agency which would take these pollinates. So cross-pollination is always dependent on agencies. Now, what could those agencies be? The agencies could be air. It could be air, wind can carry those pollen grains. It could be water. It could be insects, birds, animals, and many more. We'll write few of them more, but let us write down the name of this type of pollination. So a cross-pollination where the agency which is going to carry the pollen grain is wind or air, then it is known as anemophily. If water is going to carry it, then that would be called hydrophily. That type of pollination, and such flowers are known as anemophilous or hydrophilous. If insects are helping in this transfer of pollen grain, then it is called entomophily. If birds are doing it, then it is ornithophily. And if animals are doing it in general, like squirrels, monkeys and all, then it is known as zoophily. Let us write down about few more agencies. Bats, ants. These can also be considered as agencies, and they do help in pollination of specific plants. If bats are doing or helping in pollination, then it is known as chiropterophily. And if ants are doing it, then it is known as myrmecophily. Snails can also help in pollination. If snails help it, then it is known as malacophily. That means cross-pollination will take place only when these agencies are available. If these agencies are not there, then there is no mechanism by which the pollen grains can move from the anther to the stigma of a different plant. So these agencies are very essential. Now, these two types of pollinations, what are the importances, significance, and what are the drawbacks? In case of self-pollination, because the plant is the same, whether it is the same flower or different flowers of the same plant, that means the mixing of the same gene pool is taking place. So, over a period of time, this may result in inbreeding depression. We know that if the genes or the characters of the same gene pool mix over and over, the nature picks recessive traits. So the recombination would not take place. Recombination is very essential for evolution. So that is the only drawback. But the advantage is, because this type of pollination is not dependent on any agency, there is 100% guarantee of this transfer, fertilization, and formation of the next progeny. So, one distinct advantage, one distinct disadvantage. Here, cross-pollination is there, so mixing of two different gene pools are there. That means here, the chances of vigor would be more. That means the next generation or next progeny which is produced would have better characters of both the parents. And this would help in evolution. But the drawback is, because it is dependent on an external agency, for some reason, if that agency is not successful in transfer, then the formation of seed or production of the next generation would be difficult. For example, air. Say air is the agency and the plant is at the seashore. If this particular plant which is at seashore, say this is the water body and here is this plant that we are talking of. Say, if this plant depends on only cross-pollination, the other plants are here. If wind blows in this direction, then there is a possibility that the pollens from these plants can come to this plant stigma. But unfortunately, if when reproductive phase is going on and the wind is blowing only in this direction, so all the pollen grains would be taken away from this plant and nothing is coming from here. So chances of reproduction, continuation of the species or race would become difficult. But these plants have undergone many adaptations to ensure that though there is an external agency, still pollination would take place and fertilization would take place. So in the next part, we will take up what kind of adaptations are seen in flowers where self-pollination takes place and what kind of adaptations are seen in those flowers which